After Effects allows you to extrude and bevel text and even choose different colors for 3D surfaces. However, it typically limits you to just one bevel. In this tutorial, I'll show you a clever workaround to create more intricate and eye-catching multi-bevel 3D text, all while keeping your text fully editable. Best of all, this technique requires no plugins or pre-comping. Plus, you can even download the project file to use with your own work. Let's go. To save time, I've already set this comp with three text layers, a swatcher's guide layer, and a shape layer frame. Now, the first action is to convert all layers to 3D, except of course of the swatches. And in order to extrude them, I'll need to change my renderer from classic 3D to either advanced 3D or cinema 4D. Now, the cinema 4D one is also going to support reflections, and I'll show you how to make it work later, so keep on watching. But for the sake of speed, I'll continue with the advanced 3D. Now, to make things as simple as possible, I'll switch off all the layers except of our main title. I'll open up its settings, and for the geometry options, I'll change the extrusion depth to 100 and set the bevel style to convex. Then I'll close the geometry options for now, select the text, and press Command D, Control D on the Windows side to duplicate it. Now, I want to create a relationship between those two texts, and maybe I will have more, because for each bevel, I'll have a new duplicate. So to sort it out, I'll open up the text option, and I need to connect the source text for the main one to the duplicated one. So I'll open up its settings, and then when I'll see source text, I'll select it and double tap the letter S. SS in sequence is going to solo the selected property. Then I'll use the property pick whip and tie those two together. And this means that whatever I'll type for this text will also show up in the other copy. Now I'll close this one. I'm also going to close the entire group here and open it again because I need access to the geometry options again in this case. But before changing anything, I want to make sure that this one has a different color. So I'll select it and use the color picker to sample the blue color. Now for the bevel depth, I'll change it to the maximum value that After Effects is giving me, which is 10. And this means that now if I'll hover on top of the 3D gizmo, wait a little bit, I can see a little Z icon, which means that I can now push it behind the original text. To make it a bit more easy to control, I'll hold down the Option key, Alt on Windows, and this will give me a temporary orbit camera tool. And now I'll orbit the camera to see it from a better angle. And then what I'll do is close this guy, duplicate another copy. This one wants to be yellow, so I'll sample a yellow color. I want to create another bevel, but I want this bevel to be bigger than what we have here. Now, the reason that I can't use scale, by the way, in case you are wondering, I want to show you. If I'll open up the scale options and scale it, it doesn't look correct. You can't even do it with text animators, nor with different font types. So this is why we are working like this. All right, now that I've established the problem, let me show you the solution. So After Effects won't allow you to go beyond 10, but if you click, you can actually raise this value up to 100. So maybe 100 is just too much. I'm going to go with 20 for this instance, and then I'll push it behind the original. Now, if I just want to leave myself with the bevel and not with the fill, I can change the extrusion depth to 0. I'll hold down Option again and orbit around the scene so you can see what I'm creating. And of course, I can continue and add additional bevels as I need them. Now, you need to be very careful when you are doing it not to drag the layer, if you don't have a feel for it, above or in front of the original layer in 3D space, because you'll see the original feel. And this is due to the way After Effects 3D renders work with 3D text. A way to overcome this is to convert the text to shapes, but then you lose the ability to edit the content. Well, what can I tell you? Life is not perfect, but I think this is really nice, and I love the way it looks, and it also works in real time. Now, if we want to dress it up, maybe have some shadows or reflections, then we can go ahead and add a light. If you're using the advanced 3D renderer, we'll need to use the environment light. Make sure the cast shadows options is ticked and then click OK. If you can't see the shadows, then select all the text layers and then double tap the letter A. AA in sequence is going to show you both the geometry options as well as the material options. And over here, make sure cast shadows is turned on. And this should be enough to show us some shadows. Again, if we can't see them, or if you want to control the appearance, you can open the environment light, then drill down the transform and play with the X rotation as well as the Y rotation. And this is going to allow you to art direct the shadows. Again, I'll hold down Option, Alt on Windows and orbit around this object to show you how it looks from different directions. Now, in case you also want a reflection, then you can actually set it up inside After Effects. But for this, you'll need to switch from the advanced 3D renderer to the Cinema 4D one, which supports reflections. Now, if you do this and you have an environment light in your scene, After Effects is going to convert it to an ambient light, as you can see over here. So what we can do is double click on the light. I'll change it to point light. Make sure that I'm casting shadows. You can play with the shadow diffusion if you like, but you can already see that this is now working, looking more or less the same. You can also duplicate this point light and place another instance maybe behind the 3D title. We can even push it up, change the light intensity, make it brighter to have some specular on the edges of the letters. For the reflection, what you need is some sort of a reflection map. And you can actually create something really simple inside After Effects. So I'll create a new comp. I'll name it Reflection. I'll create a black solid. To this solid, I'll add a Venetian blinds effect. I'll set the transition completion to 50. And then to see what I'm doing, I need to toggle the transparency. I'll play with the width slider. And then we need to fill in the transparent pixels. We can easily do it by adding a solid composite effect. Right, so this is going to be our reflection. We'll return to the comp in progress, drag the reflection to this composition, right click on it and set it as an environment layer. Again, this is a feature which is currently available only for the Cinema 4D renderer. To make the text reflect this reflection as well as reflect the other instances, we need to select all the text layers, open one of them, or again, double tap the letter A to get to the material options. And then under reflection intensity, drag this value to a higher number. So let's go with something like 70. I'll close all of these guys, return to the reflection layer, then press R to show the orientation and rotation, change the Z rotation to 30 degrees. This is going to make the reflection a bit more interesting, I think. So it is angled now. And if I hold down the Option key, Alt on Windows and orbit around it, you can see how this works. And of course, this is a live reflection, so you can go back and change the settings inside the Venetian blind effects if you want it to look differently. Now, I want to remind you again that this is still a live text, meaning that if I'll double click on the little T in the timeline and type in something different, like, of course, the word text, all of the other instances are going to change automatically since they are tied with the expression. So you can add as many bevels as you need using this method. Here's an example which is part of this project that uses 6 different bevels spread across the Z axis with reflection and a simple camera move. Speaking of this project, let me show you another included comp and guide you through so you can make the most out of it. So first I'll play it. In this case, I'm animating those individual texts. And because the layers are animated, the titles are actually connected using the scale and anchor point properties. Let me show you what I mean. I'll double click on the main now layer and type in the word like. And of course, the other instances, which creates the multi-bevel, automatically updates. But if I want to move them up or down, I need to make sure that the layer is selected and then press A, and this is going to show you the anchor point, and you can move the anchor point, and this is going to keep the animation intact. Let's change now the middle line, so I'll double click on it. And in this case, I'm just going to type a single word. And this is to show you that if you need to change the frame, then the best way to do it is open up the contents, and for the rectangle path, change the X size. And this will also take care of all the duplicates. If you want, by the way, you can duplicate another bevel as well as move it or place it in a different location. And everything should work as expected. I'm also going to move its position. Again, I'm doing it from the rectangle path options. So the parametric size, position, and roundness values, these are the ones that you want to change. And lastly, I'll select the 3D text, double click to highlight it, and type the word subscribe. Of course, we need to change the scale. So I'll make sure to return to the selection tool. And I can do it from the properties panel. I'll try 85% and see if this is enough. Well, maybe 80%. And in case you want to add another bevel, make sure to duplicate the second instance. So in this case, 3D text number 2. I'll press Command D to duplicate another version. I'll sample for the fill color the pink one. And then I'll open up the geometry options and change the bevel depth to a higher value. Let's go with 30. And now we have additional bevel to what we started with. Maybe this is too much, maybe not. Again, just to rub it in, I'll return back to the original one and I'll use the anchor point of it to make it a bit more higher in the frame. So remember, you need to change the anchor point since all the text layers in this composition are animated. If you do want to change the position, you can press P. This will isolate the position. And then you need to select both keyframes by highlighting the word position and make sure that you're above one of them. And then, of course, you can change it from the timeline. But I think an easier way to work is by modifying the anchor point. So this is it. This is the way you can work with this template. I'll go to the beginning, then maximize the frame and preview the result. So I hope this is going to be useful for you. There is a link to download the project in the description box. Thank you so much for watching and make sure to come back again for more goodies in the near future.